Hey guys, Tyler again with Aaron from Winter Lumber, and today we're going to discuss trauma pads. So I have two different sizes of plates here. I have our 10x12 level 3 armor and our 11x14 level 3 armor as well. And then I have a 10x12 trauma pad and an 11x14 trauma pad. So a lot of you guys might be asking, what is a trauma pad? Well, a trauma pad is meant to be worn behind your body armor. So in between your body, then your trauma pad, and then your plate, your strike face up front. What it does is it is a non-Newtonian material, the material that we use, which basically assists in absorbing energy, which helps mitigate energy transfer through the armor upon impact to your body. So there's a couple orders of importance with body armor. One is defeating the round, and second is mitigating trauma to your body. Now, we address both concerns with body armor in general. We don't only care about defeating the round, that is obviously priority number one, but we do care about what happens to you when your plate takes a round. And there's a measurement called backface deformation. Backface deformation is a measurement in a calibrated clay unit in a testing facility, which we have on site. We use independent labs as well. And it's the baseline for certification standards. So what you do is you have this clay, which is a particular type of clay. You heat it to a certain temperature. You do a ball drop control test to make sure that the density of the clay is proper. And you put your armor up against the clay. When you shoot it, you remove the armor and you measure the depth of the clay. That is what backface deformation is, and that is how you get a consistent unit of measurement on armor tests to determine how much energy transfers through the plate and into the clay in a way you can measure. So, an interesting thing about steel armor is when already on steel, when a round impacts the plate, it has some of the best BFD numbers of any type of armor. That is because it deforms the least by comparison to polyethylene and ceramic plates, being a monolithic design. Now, if you're curious what the difference between a monolithic armor design is and something that is layered and pressed and uses resin, which is something that delaminates on impact, there's another video I highly recommend you check out called What Armor Manufacturers Don't Tell You. We go into different threat levels and different types of situations there. But specific to this, what I'm trying to say is, with trauma pads, it is an additional level of protection from blunt force trauma. But do keep in mind, we design armor with that in mind. So we always recommend running a trauma pad. They're very thin, they're very lightweight, and they're not terribly expensive compared to the armor, so it's a great thing to have. And even though our steel armor leads the industry in terms of backface deformation and how minimal and how much energy the plates actually absorb on impact, it's always a good idea to run trauma pads. So again, when you look at trauma pads, make sure you run it behind your armor. So the trauma pad is closest to your body, followed by the plate on top. And that is how you run trauma pads. If you have any questions, don't forget to let us know. And also, please do like, subscribe, and share. As you know, it's tough for anything in the firearm or body armor industry. We kind of get algorithmed out on social media, so your participation helps a lot. And thank you guys for the support. We wouldn't be here without you. And we're going to keep putting out the best quality gear we can for the price. For as long as we can. Thank you guys.